Good morning, students. In our yesterday class, we study separating of a component of a mixer. In that separation techniques, we study evaporation, centrifugation, and filtration. Students, today we discuss about distillation, chromatography, and fractional distillation. So at first we understand what is chromatography. By chromatography we can separate those components they found slightly lesser amount, minute amount found in nature. Earlier this chromatography techniques used to separate colored substance. Why? Chromatography, chroma, that word taken from a Greek word, from chroma. Chroma means color, graphy means to study of the colors. But nowadays we study those substances, they are not colored. We can separate colorless substance also. And students, you will study in detail in 11th and 12th class what is chromatography and what are the techniques. Especially chromatography depends on two techniques. One is adsorption, other one continuous separation. So, I am not going to in detail what is adsorption and continuous separation. So, preliminary I will explain some techniques. So, students, I have a chromatography paper like this, a strip, and this paper is slightly special, that known as Wattmann filter paper. That Wattmann filter paper, we write at the baseline above 2 and 3 cm, like this, we make a spot on that. And we want to separate like different ink, dye, and the other substance, those are colored. Colorless substance, we also can separate out. So we make a point above the baseline, 2-3 cm, and that point we put in a solvent. That solvent, I show you a activity, how can we occurs the chromatography separation different techniques. You know capillary tube, this one is a very fine tube, this is a capillary tube, and this tube we use for making spot. And I take a mixture of two chemical, one is safranin, other one methylene blue. You know these chemical we use in our biology lab for making slides and for staining different items, tissue. So these chemicals I mix, one is safranin, other one methylene blue, and I take a spot on this. Due to capillary action, students, you can see the chemicals move into the capillary, and I put a spot on this about 2-3 cm in this way. This is a spot. Then this filter paper, special paper, I placed in a gas jar. In this gas jar, I already filled alcohol, that is a solvent. That solvent known as sometimes eluent. I can put in water also, but these chemicals slightly less soluble in water. So I take the solvent is alcohol. Placed in this alcohol for some time. So students, carefully see, due to capillary action, that is alcohol is moved upside, and within small time, there is a movement of the particles of this safranin and methylene blue. And after some times we get a colored chromatogram. I placed 10 minutes earlier this same experiment. So I got such types paper. In this, you can clearly see I make a spot at the bottom and the movement of the alcohol particle move up to this point. Then I placed a line here, movement of the from baseline, this is a baseline. I placed the spot and the saprolene and methylene blue are separate out. Because at first I take the mixture, so this one is a, we get a colored strip, that is chromatogram, this known as chromatogram. That is saprolene and methylene blue are separate. So this technique we use for separation of colored substance. We can see, you can see now within, we put the spot and this is movement of the particles. Students clearly see that saprolene move upper side and methylene blue lower side. For some times we get a colored chromatogram like this. I placed 10 minutes earlier this two colored chromatogram paper, and so this known as chromatography technique. By this technique we can separate this substance, and we find out a factor that known as retardation factor, and this very important practical in 11th and 12th class in chemistry as well as biology. So, and very easy practical, and we can write, then we paste over this paper on our practical notebook and find out its RF value. Then student, how can we find out RF value? Now I am showing you. This one is a ink, that ink we use for that pad, on ink pad, and for making that seals and spots. So that ink, different components, and I placed for some times earlier a spot in this point, and movement of the alcohol particle move upside from this baseline to this. So in similar way, this is also separate out. So we get, this is blue ink, and this also further separate out, because this is also made by more than one component, means it is a mixture of dye. So this dye, in this way we can separate. But I place the same strip in water, that when we use this water, then this ink is not soluble in water, so this is slightly less movement in water, because water move up to this point and the ink only very slightly move. But in this alcohol, that is alcohol move up to this point, and the ink and that is a different dye separate from the baseline to this point. So this we find out a RF value. We can separate ink also by using different solvent. In alcohol is more soluble, we get clear this, and water this is slightly less soluble, so we get very less chromatogram in this way. So I can write now RF value. Students, now I showing you on blackboard. This is a filter paper. I make the spot of the 2-3 centimeters above of the baseline, and then put in a solvent. That solvent known as, special name is eluent. Eluent, a substance that move upside, maybe alcohol or water or a mixer. We take different mixers of solvent also. So this I spot, make saprolene and methylene blue. After some times I get such type chromatogram. So that is baseline, and baseline the alcohol move up to this point. Alcohol move in this up to this point. I can make a spot of alcohol, and this one is baseline. In baseline and methylene blue only move up to this, saprolene move up to this point, and the solvent move up to that point. So in way represent by this, movement of distance moved by the solvent from baseline, from Y, we can represent Y, and distance moved by the substance, that is saprolene, that is X, and the distance moved by the, that is we can write Z, by methylene blue. So in this way we can find a factor that known as RF value. RF means retardation factor. Retardation factor. You will study in 11th class this, what is RF value? Retardation factor, because there are two phases. One is stationary phase, other one mobile phase. So this filter paper act as a stationary phase and the solvent act as a mobile phase. So in this stationary and mobile phase, there is a movement of particles, that one remove that one retardation factor. So RF we can find out by distance moved by substance from baseline. For example, in this experiment we write x in centimeter, because it is distance we measure in centimeter, divided by distance moved by solvent from baseline, that is in this experiment written as by y centimeter. So in this way, this is centimeter cancel. So this value is a unitless quantity, and its value always less than 1. Its value always less than 1 or equal to 1, because solvent move more, so lower side higher value, upper side lower value, so it is always less than 1 or equal to 1. So in this way we can find. Some substances are colorless. Sometimes if the chemicals are colorless, like amino acids are colorless, then how can we find? Then we use a chemical that known as ninhydrin. We spray on that chemicals and then they are absorbed. We get a chromatogram. This colored substance known as chromatogram. If we use ultraviolet radiation, then colorless compound also show the color. And other, if we use iodine, solid iodine, we placed the colorless substance, we know iodine is sublime, so we get the color of the iodine. So these different techniques given in 11th class, you will study in detail in your syllabus. What are the chromatography? Chromatography means those substances are colored, we can separate by these techniques. And this is a different types chromatography: adsorption chromatography, paper chromatography, thin layer chromatography. So this one is a paper chromatography and this is continuous separation. And other techniques you will study in higher classes. So only in this class you remember what are these applications, what are the uses to find out drugs from blood. Students, how can we find a person take the drugs? That is blood test. In their blood found these drugs. So easily can identify by these techniques the drugs. Other one, how can we separate the juice, colored juice, by these techniques? We can separate different ink or eye ink, different colored substance by these techniques. So next technique again we explain, that is centrifugation. Yesterday we study that centrifugation, separating ice cream means cream from milk. Today we now further see what is centrifugation. Friends, now I am showing you centrifugation techniques. How can we separate that those are denser particle and lighter particle? For example, this is a substance and we want to separate this because that is denser and lighter particle present here. I placed in test tube. So now you can see there are in this four different they are funnels, this test tube, and we use by this separating funnel. I put and now start. Now we start. Now you can see the denser particles are settled down at the bottom and we get clear solution above this. That is soak powder settled down at the bottom. Due to this technique known as centrifugation, we get these are particles settled down at the bottom and we get clear solution. This techniques we use, those are lighter and denser particles. Denser are settled down easily. In this way we can separate cream from milk, and this technique we use in our dairy industry, separation of urine from blood and remove out water in washing machine from our wet clothes. So these three techniques we can apply in our washing machine, this same technique, centrifugation and urine from blood, and other one dairy product, that is cream from milk. Okay. Students, now we explain a new technique of separation of mixture, that is distillation. Distillation means those liquids are completely miscible, means there is no separate layer. And their boiling point difference is more than 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. For example, alcohol and water. In this I take alcohol and I mix water in this. So you see there is clear solution, means there is no separate layer, means completely miscible liquids. So in these liquids we want to separate alcohol and water now, because alcohol boiling point is different, 78 degrees Celsius, and water boiling point 100 degrees Celsius. So their boiling point difference is more than 20 degrees Celsius. So we can separate by distillation. Other chemical we can, I can show you, one is acetone. Students, acetone a chemical that we use to remove nail polish. So this acetone and water we mix in this, that one is a, this also a colorless liquid, acetone. In this, so this acetone, and when I mix water, then you can see this also miscible liquid. And acetone boiling point is 56 degrees Celsius, 56, and water is 100 degrees Celsius. So boiling point difference more than 25 degrees Celsius. So we want to separate these chemicals by distillation techniques. So first condition for distillation, boiling point difference, two miscible liquids, 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. Boiling point difference of both the liquid more than 20 to 25. For example, alcohol. Which alcohol? That's used to remove, means ethanol, ethyl alcohol. Normally, you will study what is alcohol. This boiling point, 78 0.5 degree Celsius, 78.5 degree Celsius. And water boiling point is, what is water boiling point? You know, water boiling point is 100 degree Celsius. So boiling point difference is near 21.5 degree Celsius. So they can separate by distillation. Other one chemical, we separate acetone. Acetone and water, both are miscible. Acetone boiling point is 56.1 degree Celsius. And water, you know, 100 degree Celsius. So easily can separate. Now we will separate by distillation. How can we take the distillation? I am showing you an activity. I am showing you the activity of distillation. So I take acetone and water in this round bottom flask, and we heating the round bottom flask. This one is a condenser. This side we supply the water, and this side remove out hot water. But now we this act as a air condenser also, because air when the vaporize, acetone first vaporize. Why? Because acetone boiling point is 56 degree Celsius and water is 100 degree Celsius. So first acetone molecule evaporate, and those molecule move to this side, and we get the acetone in this receiver. So you can see after 2 minutes the molecules of acetone are vaporized and go into this side. We start this side cold water, and that act as a water condenser. If we don't put the water, then this act as a air condenser. By air condenser, this also condense the gas. So you can see after 2 minutes. Now students, you can see the solution is like boiling, and acetone molecule evaporate. You can see here the molecule we get in this. These are acetone molecule. When I touch, then these molecules are acetone. So acetone is, you know, nail polish remover, and this molecule are first acetone evaporate, after then water also evaporate, but boiling point difference is more than 25 degree Celsius. So by this process we can separate those substance boiling point difference more than 20 to 25, like alcohol water, acetone water. So this known as distillation technique. Students, we explain what is fractional distillation. If two miscible liquid and their boiling point difference less than 20 to 25 degree Celsius, if boiling point is less than 20 to 25 degree Celsius, how can we separate out? For example, refining of petroleum. Students, we know we remove raw petroleum products from our earth crust found in very low inside the billions years. Then animals and plants are die, then it's converted into oil and petroleum in natural gas. So that petroleum is raw petroleum, found different components. First component we know that is natural gas, means methane. Other one we know LPG gas, that is a composition of ethane, propane and butane. Mainly LPG gas is butane. These three components known as LPG. This one CNG. LPG 80% is butane, and this 20% is ethane and propane composition, mainly butane. Other components like petroleum ether, petroleum ethers, petrol, diesel, kerosene,
mobile oil. These type difference are petroleum products. And how can we separate out these products? So they separate by fractional distillation. How can separate? Because their boiling point difference less than 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. For fractional distillation, we have to take a fractionality column, slightly change in this distillation condenser. I am showing that only apparatus because now I have no such type, it's required very detailed activity. So I am showing only you apparatus. Friends, in this we use a separate fractionality column like this. That is fractionality column. In this column we fill alumina gel, silica gel, and we fit like this in that condenser in apparatus. After that we use another, that is another condenser in such a way. So at first when we are heating, then what happens? The substance is boiled and they are condensed and come on the separate out. So in this way petroleum refining we get 100 feet height. In different feet heights we get different product. At first topmost height we get CNG, means natural gas. After that we get butane, ethane, this composition means LPG gas. After that we get ether, petrol, diesel, kerosene oil, and last one mobile, that is damar also, coal tar. So these are different products and they separate in industry. We have in our country there are many petroleum refining and we refine that petrol. So by that process known as fractional distillation. Students, we refine a, we can separate another component, that is component of air. Students, how can we separate the different component of air? We want to separate out the component of air. So at first we know what are the component present in the air. First component is nitrogen, that is highest percent by volume, that is 78.1% by volume. By volume, nitrogen 78.1. Second component is oxygen, that is 20.9%. Third component is argon, that is 0.9%. Fourth component, that is carbon dioxide, 0.03%, very less. Other are air gas, water vapors, helium, neon, other gases also. So students, this one is a composition of the air. In this composition, how can we separate these different components? At first, this air we want to convert into liquid air. Liquid air. Because liquid can separate by distillation. And those liquid, their boiling point difference less than 20 to 25, they separate by fractional distillation. So at first this air we want to convert into liquid air. Friends, so how can we convert a gaseous into liquid state? We already studied in first chapter. We can convert a gaseous component. For example, so in this container present gaseous molecule and there is a large space between the molecules. Less force of attraction. We use a piston in this and apply that piston pressure. So what happens if you apply very high pressure? This one is air composition. And if you apply this very high pressure in this, by applying piston in this way, so all the molecules are settled down and they come to near to each other. And when they come near, then they convert into liquid state. So this one is liquid air. Liquid air. So what factors, how can we convert air into liquid air? First factor is high pressure. We have to apply high pressure. So what happens? Molecule come to near. Another factor is, second factor, that is energy. Kinetic energy, you know, directly proportional to temperature. We already studied in first chapter. It means when temperature increase, kinetic energy increase, speed of molecule increase. But we want to decrease because in air the molecule speed is high, but in liquid molecule speed is lower. So we have to decrease the temperature. The second condition for making liquid air, decreasing temperature. Decrease temperature. So when temperature decrease, moment decrease, kinetic energy decrease, molecule come to near and force of attraction. So this convert into liquid air. So students, in your NCERT book at page number 22 given, a tabular form, that is oxygen, nitro, argon and nitrogen. In this, they are given boiling point. These three gaseous components are higher amount of the in the air, that is 20.9, argon 0.9 and nitrogen near 78. And 78 or 78.1, only 0.1 the other gases are present. So oxygen boiling point is minus 183 degrees Celsius, given in your NCERT book. This argon boiling point minus 186 degrees Celsius, only 3 degrees Celsius difference, and nitrogen minus 196 degrees Celsius. So oxygen and nitrogen boiling point difference is what? Only 13 degrees Celsius. So they can't separate by normal distillation, so they separate by fractional distillation. So these techniques, other one, which gas is first remove out? You know students, carbon dioxide also, and carbon dioxide is also available in the air, and carbon dioxide boiling point is 31.1 degrees Celsius. So at first this carbon dioxide is separated out. A schematic diagram given in your NCERT book at page number 23. You can see how can there is a diagram given in your NCERT book, page number 23. You can see how can convert a gas into liquids. So at first this carbon dioxide is separated out when we apply high pressure and decrease temperature. So this carbon dioxide remove out as a dry ice. Why dry ice? Because direct change into gaseous to solid state, and due to this reduced temperature. So this converts dry ice, like it is very cool, temperature is lower, so separate out. Other one, after that, at first we remove oxygen gas. After carbon dioxide we remove oxygen. Why? Because oxygen is more boiling point than argon and nitrogen. Because negative 183, so this one is higher boiling point than argon and nitrogen. So argon and nitrogen, and last we get nitrogen. So in similar way, we can separate by fractional distillation, and we use these gas, different gases in the different atmosphere. So these are techniques we can separate petroleum refining and air. In this way students, if you have any problem, then you can ask in comment box. Tomorrow we will discuss about what is crystallization and physical and chemical change. In next two video, this chapter is over. So after that, we start the question answer by Google form. If you have any problem, then write, and we will explain in next videos. So like and subscribe. Thank you. Have a nice day.